How seeds implant themselves in soil can seem magical. Take some varieties of Erodium, whose five-petaled flowers of purple, pink or white look like geraniums. The seed of these plants is carried inside a thin, tightly wound stalk. During rain or high humidity, the corkscrew-like stalk unwinds and twists the seed into the soil, where it can take root and is safe from hungry birds and harsh environmental conditions. Inspired by Erodium's magic, Lining Yeo, assistant professor at Carnegie Mellon University, worked with a team of collaborators to engineer a biodegradable seed carrier referred to as e-seed. The seed carrier, fashioned from wood veneer, could enable aerial seeding of difficult-to-access areas and could be used for a variety of seeds or fertilizers and adapted to many different environments. It is an idea that Yeo, the daughter of part-time farmers, has pondered since she was a PhD student at MIT in the mid-2010s. Seed burial has been heavily studied for decades in terms of mechanics, physics, and material science. But until now, no one has created an engineering equivalent. The seed carrier research has been particularly rewarding because of its potential social impact. The team's research appeared in the journal Nature. Erodium's stalk forms a tightly wound seed-carrying body with a long curved tail at the top. When it begins to unwind, the twisting tail engages with the ground, causing the seed carrier to push itself upright. Further unwinding creates torque to drill down into the ground, burying the seed. But Erodium's one-tailed carrier only works well on soils with crevices. To employ their e-seed carriers in a broader range of environments, the research team developed a three-tailed version that is more efficient at pushing itself upright. The researchers considered a number of possible materials for their carriers, including hydrogels, paper, and other forms of processed cellulose. They ultimately chose veneers of white oak, a species of tree abundant in Sindley Park adjacent to the CMU campus in Pittsburgh, and widely used in furniture. Like Erodium, veneers respond to moisture. Growing up in Inner Mongolia, Yeo learned early from her parents the importance of timing the seeding process with the prospect of rain. Her appreciation for that timing grew during this project, as the researchers did plenty of field testing of the carriers rather than just lab tests. That meant they had to keep their eyes on the weather, rushing the carriers to a test field when rain was in the offing. The team developed a five-step process, including both chemical washing and mechanical molding, to manufacture the seed carriers. Although the carriers are currently fabricated in the lab, the researchers anticipate adopting the process to an industrial scale. In addition to seeds, the researchers demonstrated they could use the carriers to deliver nematodes, that is, worms used as natural pesticides, fertilizers and fungi. Work is also underway to adopt them for planting seedlings. The carriers also could be used to implant sensors for environmental monitoring. They might also assist in energy harvesting by implanting devices that create current based on temperature fluctuations.